Hi, today we're going to learn about Ohm's law, the basic concepts and definitions. So before we talk about the Ohm's law itself, let's remember what are electric current and resistance. Well, the electric current is actually the rate at which charge flows. So we can calculate the current using this formula. That's the variation in charge over time. You can think about like in a wire. We have electrons passing by it. So we have electric charges that are passing through this area here. And this charge flow is actually the electric current. Now for resistance, is an electric property that impedes the current. So is a resistance to the current to flow, for the charge electric particles to flow. So we can calculate for a wire, for example, this cylindrical wire, using this formula. We have the resistivity of the material, the length of the wire, and the area, okay, this transactional area here of the wire. So we can calculate the resistance using this formula here. It's proportional to the length and area. All right, so the Ohm's law, this name here was given after this guy here, George Simon Ohm, and he did some experiments with a simple circuit where he would vary the voltage, the resistance, okay, leaving some of those things constant. And he discovered that the current is directly proportional to the voltage applied to it. So in the same circuit with the same electric current, the same resistance, when he varied the voltage, he saw that, well, the current was changing also, and it's also inversely proportional to the resistance in the circuit. So by this, he developed the Ohm's law. So the electric current is actually the voltage divided by resistance, or you can also write it like this, right? The voltage is actually the resistance times the electric current. And for this thing here, the current, we give the unit of 1 ampere. So 1 ampere is actually 1 volt divided by 1 ohm. Okay, ohm is the unit of the resistance. All right, now let's apply this concept, the Ohm's law, into a simple circuit like this. Okay, imagine this flashlight circuit. So the light is actually, the light bulb is the resistance. Okay, we have the batteries here, and of course an electric current going through this circuit here. Let's suppose that the voltage of the battery is 1.5 volts. And the resistance of the light here, the flashlight, is 3.6 ohms, okay? So, well, we want to calculate the current. We can just apply Ohm's law for it. So we have the voltage, the resistance, so the electric current in this circuit here is actually 0.42 amperes. Okay, now it's your turn to think about this problem here. So what is the effect of a long extension cord in an electric appliance? Let's change a little bit. Now it's not a flashlight. Imagine your computer, for example, your laptop, okay, or even your cell phone when it's charging. And what happens to the current if you have a really long extension cord? Remember the formula to calculate the resistance in a wire, for example. And, well, If you change that resistance, what changes here with the current and what may happen to you, to your electric appliance when you change this current here? Think about it and write your answers in the comment sections.
Now that you watched this video, you're one step closer to achieving your academic goals. Well done! There's always more to learn, so check out our other videos and don't forget to subscribe.